you, Madam President. I have the honor to deliver this statement on behalf of the Non-Aligned Movement. The full version of the statement will be available at the extranet. NAM welcomes High Commissioner's determination to further strengthen constructive engagement with member states on both bilateral and multilateral human rights issues. Madam President, we thank the High Commissioner for her efforts in advancing human rights promotion at the global level. High Commissioner Michelle Bachelet leads the office in a crucial moment for the United Nations and for the international community in face of a world in which human rights norms are under big threat and attack. Madam President, we share High Commissioner's concern about severe acts of multiple forms of discrimination in many regions, widespread violations of economic and social rights, violations of human rights in the context of counterterrorism and attacks motivated by stereotypes and hatred of many kinds. Madam President, global human rights challenges, including deteriorating democratic values, ongoing and protracted conflicts, inequality, poverty, and racial and other forms of discrimination, are on the rise around the world. Therefore, the expectations of UN member states from the work of the High Commissioner and her office are adequately higher than ever. While exercising duties in relation to the UN member states, the High Commissioner must bear in mind the existing challenges and national context and circumstances of member states to exercise objectivity, independence, and impartiality in her actions, avoiding imposing new practices and to favor constructive dialogue and cooperation, as well as to provide advisory services, technical and financial assistance upon request of the states concerned, with a view to supporting their actions and programs in the field of human rights. Increased number of human rights violations of victims, including IDPs and refugees, because of ongoing wars and armed conflicts around the world, necessitates High Commissioner to pay more focused attention to these vulnerable people and to take efficient actions for restoring their violated rights. Madam President, finally, the movement reaffirms its commitment to constructively work with the High Commissioner to strengthen the credibility of human rights apparatus and to build an international order based on inclusion, mutual understanding, and respect for cultural diversity. I thank you.
Thank you very much.